Good day, everyone. Happy weekend to you all. This Lenten season has come and gone so quickly. We are now into Holy Week, and the drama is about to unfold. And what a drama it is. An arrest, a court trial, betrayal, abuse, brutality, friendship, love, loyalty, all ending in a very brutal execution, one of the worst ever invented by mankind. It is about to unfold before our very eyes. So sit back and take it all in. Holy Week is like no other week on the Catholic calendar. You will go through all the emotions, sorrow and sadness, joy and elation. My question to us this Holy Week is, where are you in all this? And I will be using that refrain throughout my talk today. Where are you in Holy Week? Where are you in the story? The gospel story is really our story. Where are you in the story? I'm going to look at some of the characters and ask you to see whether you can relate to any of them, because they all represent various attributes that we find in the human person. It's an examination of the self as we enter Holy Week. Are you the religious authorities, the ones who instigated the entire proceedings, the scribes and Pharisees? John 18:12 tells us, then the detachment of soldiers with its commander and Jewish officials arrested Jesus. They bound him and brought him to Annas, who was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, the high priest for that year. Caiaphas was the one who had advised the Jewish leaders that it would be good if one man died for the people. Now notice the reference to the Jewish officials. Is that you? The accusing type, jealous, legalistic, unforgiving, sitting on the side, pointing fingers and finding flaws. There are some people who just love to sit on the side and point fingers. They have what you might call a critical attitude. They know what everyone is doing wrong from their position of superiority. Is that where you are in the story? Oh, my dear friends, are you part of the crowd? What an interesting group. Crucify him, crucify him. Is that you? Some people like the crowd. It is where you lose all sense of yourself. You have no individuality. You just follow along. In a crowd, you don't know whether you are going or coming. It is such a comfortable place to be. But God did not make us this way. We are all individuals. We are unique. We were given the ability to decide and choose for ourselves. But is that where you are in your life right now? Oh, my friends, are you one of the soldiers? John records, and I quote, the detachment of soldiers with their commander arrested Jesus. Later, they would go on to brutalize him, poke fun at him, mock him. Is that your style? Abuse, manipulation, control? Sometimes in life, we have to ask someone who knows us well for an honest appraisal of our character. And you might be quite surprised, there just might be a bit of soldier in all of us. Bullying, belittling, teasing, initiating gossip, slander, and ill will, and enjoying seeing others fall. That is the soldier in all of us. Our lives are filled with lies, with malice, with gossip. The gospel story is my story. Where am I in this story? Or are you Peter? Or the disciples filled with fear and doubt? Some people, their mantra is, I really don't know. I'm not quite sure. John 18:25 records that Peter was standing and warming himself. So a bystander said to him, you are also one of the disciples, aren't you? And he denied it and said, I am not. One of the servants of the high priest asked him, Who is it? Did I not see you in the garden with him? And Peter again denied it. And at once, we are told, a rooster crowed. So in the face of difficulty, we run away, we escape, we hide. It's called being wishy-washy. We make excuses. We say it is inconvenient, it wasn't the right time, we are not quite sure, the situation was different. We become a skilled debater. We learn how to embellish the truth. And we have fancy words for everything. We call adultery an indiscretion in our language. Alcoholism is social drinking. Pornography is free press. Abortion is just terminating a pregnancy. We have words and cute phrases for lots of things which are either wrong or just blatantly sinful. The passion story is my story. Where am I in the story? Probably the most interesting character and the most relevant is Pilate, the man who asked Jesus, "What is truth?" Pilate asked all the right questions. Take him yourself and pass judgment on him. Are you the king of the Jews? What have you done? Pilate is the symbol of the modern man. He takes the modern stance of arrogance, a kind of what you might call philosophical cynicism. What is truth? What rubbish are you talking about? What he's saying in effect is that religion is really a private matter. Stay in your corner. This is also the stance of lots of modern governments as well. Don't bring your religious practices into the public domain. And in response to Jesus' remark that he has come into the world to testify to the truth, many people respond by saying, "Well, keep your superstition to yourself. I wash my hands of the matter." Pilate decided apparently to take the middle road, not to choose. And many people today have decided to live like that. They have decided not to choose. They will not be like Simon of Cyrene, who took a risk and decided to help Jesus to carry his cross. He decided to stand out. He decided to commit. Many people prefer to stand on the side and simply wash their hands, to sit on their fence in their own private world, because commitment is a risk. It will complicate our lives and make it too difficult. It would not be convenient. So do the convenient thing. Let the people decide and allow them to make the choice. Jesus or Barabbas? But my dear friends, convenience is not truth. At some point, you have to decide. Are you for Jesus? The message of Holy Week is simply this. Are you for the Lord? Are you willing to commit? You have to decide, and you can't simply sit on the fence anymore. Because, my dear friends, the truth is a man. Have a happy and holy week. God bless you all.